Okay, there's just something I have to get off my chest. According to the government, the official unemployment rate in this country is now 9.4%. Now, I won't get into how the official unemployment rate excludes discouraged workers. It excludes part-time workers who want to work full-time and on and on and on. But let me just say this. It dropped from 9.5% to 9.4%. But we lost 247,000 jobs. That's a net loss of 247,000 jobs. How can you lose jobs, 247,000 jobs in 1 month, and then have a decrease in unemployment? That makes absolutely no sense. No, we're not losing jobs at the same rate that we did earlier in the year, but we're still losing jobs. So how in the hell can unemployment actually go down? It makes absolutely no sense. This sounds really ridiculous. Anyway, I've been doing some reading. I hooked up with somebody and they said the author was going to send me a free copy of this book. It's called Patriots, a novel of survival in the coming collapse. Yeah, I'm reading it and I'm loving it. I'm reading it right now. It's a pretty good book. No, I'm not being paid by the author or anybody, but I like what I'm reading. With a superheated economy, there was no way for the government to check soaring inflation aside from stopping the presses. This they could not do, however, because depositors were still flocking to the banks to withdraw all of their savings. One radio show host described the situation as watching a snake eat its own tail. All that the bureaucrats in Washington, D.C. could do was watch it happen. They had sown the seeds decades before when they started deficit spending. Now they were reaping the whirlwind. The workers who still had jobs quickly caught on to the full implications of mass inflation. They insisted on daily inflation indexing of their salaries, and in some cases even insisted on being paid daily. Citizens on fixed incomes were wiped out financially by hyperinflation within 2 weeks. These included pensioners, those on unemployment insurance, and welfare recipients. Few could afford to buy a can of beans when it cost $150. The riot started soon after inflation bolted past 1,000% by the 1,000% mark. Detroit, New York, and Los Angeles were the first cities to see full-scale rioting and looting. Soon, the riots engulfed most other large cities. The only voices of doubt came from the Laytons and Dan Fong. When Todd first called Dan before his trip back from the accounting firm meeting, Dan listened to his full spiel and then remarked that, "Yeah, Todd, remember what happened after the September 11th attacks? You went positively ape. You were Chicken Little and the sky didn't fall, now did it? I remember the emergency meeting that we had at TK's. You were really panicky. You even had Mary loading magazines from stripper clips during the meeting, as I recall. Now, how do you know this isn't just another false alarm?" Dan's doubts disappeared a few days later when he was on his way to work. He slowed down when he saw a queue of people stretching a full block. It ended at the doors of the first Chicago bank on Columbus Avenue. "Oh man," he commented out loud to himself. "It's 6 o'clock in the morning and they are already lined up. This looks way serious." He remembered that bank lines were on one of Todd's trouted warning signs. Turning the corner, Dan had to stop and gawk. Along with other drivers, a man was smashing an ATM machine with a tire iron. The machine was obviously either out of cash or had been shut down by the bank. The man was still in the process of venting his rage with the tire iron when Dan drove away. Yeah, I really like this book. It's sort of like fiction and nonfiction mixed up all together. It's sort of like a documentary in a sort of a way, because it sort of details what the author believes is going to happen in the future. And I don't know, this is just pretty cool. I'm also reading The Fourth Reich, The Rise of the Fourth Reich. This is by Jim Mars. It's called The Rise of the Fourth Reich. secret societies that threaten to take over America. As you can see, topic like that will definitely get my attention. All right, now that you know what I'm reading, I want to know what you're reading. What books are you reading right now? What's genres? What's the author? Kind of curious about that. Anyway, feel free to rate this video, comment. Have a good day. Bye.